Hello, my name is Kim Banner. I'm a senior scientist at D2 in Energy, and I'm also heading a section called Structural Design and Testing. Besides that, I'm project manager for a very large project called ReliaBlade. And together with my colleague, Marcin Lusak, we will today tell you more about this project and also how we are using digital twins to improve the reliability of wind turbines. But before I do that, I will just say a few words about D2 Wind Energy and the background for this project. D2 Wind Energy is a world-leading university department for wind energy, and we work towards making wind energy the best possible source of energy. We are, as you know, currently seeing a transformation of the world towards more digitalization, but we are also in the middle of a transformation of the energy systems in the world. We see a much higher electrification of the world, more and more become electric, and we are also moving towards much more renewable energy into the energy systems. And a year ago, the International Energy Agency presented this report. And it showed the huge potential for offshore wind. And it also predicted that offshore wind or wind will become the biggest source of energy in the future energy systems. The yellow in this figure shows the demand for electricity in different regions of the world. And the blue so show the potential for offshore wind. So you see that in particular in Europe, the potential is huge. Also, another report came out about a year ago, and this report showed that we already in 5 to 10 years from now can fly, drive on synthetic fuels. Offshore wind is particularly well suited for making this kind of fuels. So you take the hydrogen from water, for instance, and the CO2 from the atmosphere, and with electricity that can be made into an artificial fuel that are carbon neutral. In Denmark, the government has this year taken steps towards establishing what we call energy islands with the purpose of making green carbon neutral fuel from wind energy. However, there are challenges to be solved for making wind energy even more economical feasible, because there are difficulties and with the maintenance offshore, and that and it's also expensive to do it offshore. So that is why we have made this project ReliaBlade. The project purpose is to overcome these challenges. We work towards making wind turbines more reliable and to reduce the cost of maintenance by applying digital twins of the blades over their entire life cycle. And you can see there are many partners in the project, and it's also special because it's combining two national funded projects, a Danish and a German. And together, the budget is about 18 million euro. So this slide shows the vision for the project. So you can imagine that in the future, when a blade leaves the factory, it's not just the physical blade leaving the factory, but it comes with a digital twin of that unique blade. Because blades are unique, there are small variation, imperfections coming from the manufacturing process. Also material properties may be slightly different depending on the manufacturing. And we work in the project with scanning technologies to detect these imperfections so they can be included in the digital twin, and therefore making each blade unique. By applying sensors to the blades, we can then monitor what happens to the blades during its lifetime. And there will be damage growing in the blades as they are loaded, and these sensors can detect these damage growth and update the digital twin accordingly. So it always represents the true state of the physical blade. With a digital twin, it's then possible to take decisions. For instance, when it comes to a time when the blade is needing repair, the digital twin can be used to simulate different repair methods, and from that take decision which one is the best fitted for this particular damage. You can also use the digital twin to take decisions on how to operate the turbine, so damage will not grow further. So there's a lot of opportunities and possibilities with digital twins, and the industry is very interested in this. I will shortly go through some of the different steps and partners in the project. One of the unique things with the project is also that we make our own blade design. We make two different blades in this project, a 31 meter long blade, manufactured by our German partner, Fraunhofer Ives. And then we at D2 have designed a small 12.6 downscale version of this blade. And the unique thing here is that these designs are open. So we can share all the information about how the blades are made, lay out the material properties, which normally are not something you can have if you work with commercial blades. So this makes also this project unique. We built artificial and on-purpose defects and damage into the blades. So we have identified a number of different damage types that are important for the industry, and we will in each of these different blades build in different types of damage and defects, so we can monitor how these grow and we can scan them and detect them with the scanning technologies. So the blades are manufactured. As I said, the 31 meter blade will be manufactured by Fraunhofer Ives, and we are together at D2, together with the partner Olsen Wings, are manufacturing the smaller blades. Here are some of the different scanning technologies that will be used. We have a partner, Cibicon, that work with camera-based scanning technologies, and this will be used to scan the 3D geometry of the blades, both outer and inner surfaces. And from that, we can update the digital twin so it represents the true geometry of the blade. Also, we work with two partners working with NDT methods. We have Dantec Dynamics working with a method called laser geography and Forza technology with the ultrasound scanning. And these methods can be used to detect defects, things under the surface, inside the structure, and with that, describe them digital and include them in the digital twins. We are not putting the blades on operating turbines in this project. We are instead testing the blades under realistic operating loads in our test facility at D2, and we will then be monitoring the blade and to detect the damage that is growing. So in the lab environment, we can apply much more different type of measuring systems. And here's a list of some of the measuring systems that we will use in the project. We have a partner, Seco Sensors, that are developing a sensor type that has will show very promising to be built into blades in the future, so be part of the monitoring system. But in the lab, we also apply a number of different other measuring systems, so we will have a good understanding and a measurement of what's going on in the blades as damage will grow. We are then having IBM as a partner in the project, and they provide what's an IoT cloud platform for the project. So the sensor data, measuring data, will be streamed to the cloud. And then with machine learning, we can then build the applications and monitoring and analyze these data to indicate that damage is evolving inside the blade. And we have Siemens Industry Software as an important partner with all the expertise on digital twins, and also working with updating models based on measurements. I'll now give the word to Marcin Lusak, who will tell more about the work that we do with Siemens Industry Software.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Marcin Lusak. I work at DTU Wind Energy as a senior researcher. And within next 10 minutes, I will try to present highly international, intersectoral, and interdisciplinary research activity we have in cooperation with Siemens Digital Industry Software. Many people have contributed to this presentation. You will find a list of participating persons on this slide. And my presentation will be structured towards presenting the research activity of the wind turbine blade, and in the second part of development digital twin based on the desktop demo mockup. We are using a rich portfolio of a SimCenter products, starting from the experimental activities where we use a test lab, and then simulation activities on AMESIM and finite element method in SimCenter 3D. In our blade testing, we are focusing on structural dynamic identification with the experimental model analysis, and we correlate those results with the simulations from the models. In a free boundary condition, we identify a structural dynamics of the blade, measuring the response of the blades at different locations to estimate parameters of the models, such as natural frequencies, mode shapes, and corresponding damping part. In parallel, we are developing a fully 3D finite element model, and the yellow dots on this slide denote the location of the accelerometers during the experimental test. And we are running the correlation analysis where we correlate the modes and frequencies obtained from measurement and from simulation. And of course, we are using them to improve the model of FE. We are doing the same for the in-house DTU code for aeroelastic simulation to validate the results from these simulations as well. Of course, we are also running a destructive testing during the fatigue of the wind turbine blade. We are utilizing the opportunity of a strain-based operational model analysis, because the blade is heavily instrumented with the multitude of the strain gauges, which are not a traditional transducers used for the operational model analysis. But still, we are able to identify the structural properties and also apply them for evaluation of the progressive damage and the structural deterioration of the blade as the fatigue cycles increase. In the next part, I will focus on the desktop demo mockup and present how do we develop a concept of the digital twin. We decided to represent such a complex and large structure as a blade with a simple cantilever beam fixed on the bed plate and the block for our work. In the first step, we are running experimental campaign to identify the mode shapes and frequencies of the mockup. And in parallel, in cooperation with the Siemens team, we develop a new functionality which is online streaming of the data to the IBM cloud. Once the measurement is activated, the signals from the transducers is delivered to so-called devices defined in the cloud, and it is storing the data there and made it available for any other simulation applications as well. One of the enablers for the digital twin functionality is a fast computation of the and updating of the model. So for this reason, we have developed a model of the beam. In the future, it will be also a model of the blade in AMSI. And it provides us the functionality of the fast computing of the natural frequencies and modes. We are also applying this model for implementation of the concept of virtual channels. So in case of limited number of the true or real accelerometers deployed on the structure, the remainder of the information can be obtained from the validated model in AMSI. We are also exporting this model to FMU interface, which enables us to plug it as a component into a high-performance computing environment and interact with other models linked through an input and output data flows, including the IBM cloud stored data. Of course, in parallel, we are developing a full 3D FE model of the structure to get more insights into capacity of damage modeling and progress of deterioration of the structural properties of that. So in short, we are using the rich portfolio of the SimCenter platform to enable a digital twin of our blade. And of course, the work does not stop here, as we are looking into next steps, which are embedding the machine learning methods for automated model updating, and also towards the structural health monitoring. Thank you for your attention. And I would like to acknowledge the funding agencies which sponsor this research.
I will then end the presentation by giving you a future outlook on the use of digital twins and also summarize some highlights from the ReliaBlade project. In the ReliaBlade project, we have a really strong consortium with very long time experience from WIN. And we also have an open blade design where we can share all information about the blades with the partners, and the vision is also to share it with the outside world. We work with blade manufacturing, having advanced process measuring technologies, and we also in the project develop more advanced blade modeling tools. We work on creating a digitalization platform where all the partners in the project can apply their different technologies, and all data is integrated into a digital twin. We will then use data analytics and artificial intelligence, with particular IBM and D2 compute, to see how sensors can detect damage growth and create a condition monitoring systems. We therefore work towards changing current operation of wind turbines from a fixed scheduled intervals of inspections or reactive when something goes wrong, to a future where it's more predictive maintenance based on of data and condition monitoring. If you are interested to hear more about the project or are interested in our work, you are very, very welcome to contact us. Thank you very much for your attention.